offer trainings to your clients?
Fire Brigade comes up and puts some musomo, of like, today we are at Cricket Oval. We want to train people on how to put off a fire. Those with half fire extinguishers, it is a ticket for you to come for this what? For this training on how to put off fire, because they tend to really come late. I don't know whether it is about the person who has communicated or the traffic that they have. So for that time, as they come, let them make sure they train Ugandans in case of a scenario like this, how do you safeguard yourselves from fire, and give them those free tips. Because me, when I come to train like a school, I will charge them money. I will charge you some money, yeah, to cater for those services. But let the government also offer it as free of charge.
So let us talk about the counterfeit products that we've always known in Uganda. Do fire extinguishers also have duplicates?
As Uganda fire experts, we are very genuine in our services. I've known a scenario where you have counterfeit services. I know they are there. I know they are there. We, as any other industry that is growing up, people tend to cover themselves in a sense of looking for money. Well, the more you look for cheap products, the more you get counterfeit products or counterfeit services. Why would you hire someone to sell you a fire extinguisher who has no company that is registered under a fire protection association, which is Fire Brigade, who has no office, who's not legible enough to be your service provider? So I mean, as clients also, or customers, we don't know what we want. You tend to, how do I explain it in Luganda? Because you want to, you want cheap services, cheap money. That is the rule. Cheap services, cheap money. Before you look out as a client, first know, is this company registered? In case of anything, where do I find them? Is it registered under is it called URSPS? Is this a genuine company? In case of anything, can this person come back to me? Are their contacts on? Do they have a fully functional office or their briefcase? Or it's just a normal shop that is selling maybe retail goods, and you find a fire extinguisher there and you say, give me one. How sure it is this fire extinguisher is safe? I think my call is to, or my advice is to call upon all clients to know their service providers, to know where they are physically located, and to know the types of services they do. Take initiative, go visit your supplier, get concerned, get to know their location, get to know whatever they do, and get to know, are they the member of Fire Brigade? Are they recognized by Fire Brigade? Because we have an association right now, which is Fire Brigade, that is recommending us or recognizing you to be one of the operators in fire safety. That is another way. And water, we're already phasing it out because we have electricity. And so another thing would be a sand. Well, now we've seen sand buckets on petrol stations. You've seen them. Yes, that's very sand. So you must have some sand buckets. You can dip it in fire. Let's say furniture is on fire. You can dip maybe a normal blanket. Our woolen blanket. If you can dip it in water, then you can cover. But all that time you put in, remember fire is very fast. Very, very fast. Of course, before these fire extinguishers, we had a way of protecting ourselves. Our great parents had their way of how they can protect themselves from fire. Yeah, so for example, like at home, if you can have sand, we have also sand, it can put off fire. Yeah, so we've seen sand on petrol stations. We can also acquire that at our homes. Great sand buckets, some sand positions somewhere, so that we keep sand at our homes as well. You can cover what is burning. You can pour it. Okay. Or you pour it in a computer or a TV or a kettle, but it can put off they're fine. Then another scenario which is not safe is also using a normal cloth or a blanket. You dip it in water and cover what is burning. But if you use that, you must make sure that there is no electricity involved. And also it is not good because there is a time frame, the time you get the blanket, dip it in water. Remember the fire is what? Is moving. So I wouldn't, what I urge all of you is to have a fire extinguisher. All this may be very efficient, but there is time involved. And fire moves at the very fastest rate that you can never imagine. Very fast rate. So still, I will stick on the fire extinguishers. But before fire extinguishers, there are some other improved systems that we can use. We have a fire blanket. We have our fire blanket here. This fire blanket is made out of fiberglass. We call it fiberglass. Yeah, this one is used, but we have a new one here. This one we have used it like two to three times. You can use it 2 to 3 times as you wash it and keep. Wash and keep 2 to 3 times. So this is how it looks like. It is very white when it is still new. Now this one we have used it. So the way we use this fire extinguisher is either you see someone on the cooker covering what is burning. So this kind of the fire blanket, you use it to cover what is burning or cover your body to evacuate out, to get out of the building. So the white one looks like this is the new fire blanket. So it does not burn. When we take you through a session of firefighting, even you put your mother will eat it, it does not burn. It only covers, suffocates the oxygen, because we believe in fire, oxygen supports burning. So it cuts off all the oxygen supply.
And then the fire dies out.
So when you're covering, make sure there is no hole that oxygen will pass. You make sure you cover completely. No window, no small hole where the oxygen will pass. Or else in case you're in a building or a home that is already covered with a lot of flames, if you use this fire blanket, cover it on your body, hold, make sure that, you know, these strips are the ones you hold from inside the cloth. These are the strips you hold from inside the cloth, and you cover your body and get out of the safely. So if schools can also have these in their dormitories, so that kids, or in case of any fire outbreak, use them. In a school, two people can use it to cover themselves and get out.
Maybe the rest can follow this person leaving.
Exactly, yeah. So let the schools also have these fire blankets installed in the dormitories. Yeah, it can also help to save, because if the deaf died that they cannot hear, but I know they were seeing, so this could have helped to get out of that. Yeah. And also in schools, I realize I think they don't provide escape routes. We have burglar everywhere, the doors are locked. Yeah, so you can imagine what happens. So let us also build in a way considering fire. In case there is a fire outbreak, is there an emergency door? An emergency door for someone to use to evacuate.
This is the used one after putting out fire, right? And it can be washed and used again.
For a fire extinguisher, which is a carbon dioxide, it is a gas. It is given this big hose pipe because it is a gas. And this is the best way you can describe that. This is a carbon dioxide gas fire extinguisher. If you find it without any word, and you saw it has this kind of a hose, you know automatically this is a carbon dioxide, which is a gas. Gas tends to move out in a wider spread. So it is, for it what it does, why it is this big, it is a wider spread, so that it smoothens the fire. Whereas this one suppresses the fire. This suppresses the fire. It has a lot of energy. It suppresses the powder. It pops out with force and pressure. Suppress the fire. This one smoothers. Now this fire extinguisher, I'll use this small one, okay, which is near me. You see it has a gauge, we call this as a gauge. This one we call it a head valve. This one we call it a nozzle. So the gauge, you're saying whether it is, you have it, it has different colors. It has white, green and red.
Exactly.
It has white, green and red. But this one has red, red. Before this side used to be white, then in the middle green, then this side red. But
and
they made
it me.
So when it is this side, when the gauge, you see it has that yellow, that like a compass in the middle. When it is clockwise, or this side where zero starts, you see there are numbers. When it is in zero, meaning there is no pressure. If you use this fire extinguisher, it won't come out, because for a powder, it uses pressure to power up the powder outside. You can have the powder inside, but no pressure. The fire extinguisher won't work because there is no energizer, the energy to get out that. So this powder, this fire extinguisher, I'm taking now to chemistry. It has reagents inside. When it has, when there are two reagents in a certain container, they need a regulator to balance. So that's why you have this gauge. So when it is down, it is in zero. Powder, which is potassium. Sorry, not potassium. It is phosphate, ammonium phosphate. And then we have the nitrogen gas. The balance is the gauge that is balancing them.
And the pressure?
The pressure, I told you, is acting as an energizer. When the gauge goes down, meaning there is no pressure, maybe someone squeezed it, tampered with it. That's why I told you about the service. You may have children at home when they've already pressed it and you don't know. And this fire extinguisher is one use, one single use like this. There's nothing like they may press a little use and I keep. Once you have pressed and the valve has gone inside, you bring it immediately for service. When you press it, maybe by accident, maybe someone has played on it, maybe you have used it, bring it back for service. There is no using it and keeping it. So the gauge, when the gauge is this side to zero, no pressure. When it is in green, it is in operational mode. In green, it is overpressurized. So meaning it is risky for you. Meaning someone who refilled it or who serviced it has gone beyond the limitation, so which it must be in green. So it is prone to bursting, exploding and killing and endangering people. The reason why this one does not have a gauge is because it is a compressed gas. It is only one reagent in this cylinder, which is only carbon dioxide. Wherever you are in Western region, in Northern region, in the Central, Eastern, Southern region, please, I call upon all of you to implement safety in your homes. Implement safety at your workplaces. Look at the money you put in when you're building this house. Look at the money you put in when you're building this business. And look in how safe you can keep it forever, even for your great-grandchildren. Look at the lives that have died due to fire. Look at the children we have lost due to fire in schools. I urge all of you, please have fire extinguishers and follow the safety standards of servicing them, of continuously training your people at home, training your children at school. Those refresher training must be there every now and then. Because new people come in, new people go. Like, it has to be continuous. So I call upon you to implement safety, fire safety in your homes, in your schools, in your hospitals, in your factories, in your offices, and follow up the maintenance. Follow up the maintenance. Why am I saying it three times? People don't service their fire extinguishers. They don't. And actually, you go there, they tell you the fire has never come this year, so it won't come. So you can imagine the ignorance that we have, the adamancy that we have. So let us be safety conscious and be positive. There are no challenges. Actually, the challenge is yourself. You're good to go. Your family, your home is safe. Take a scenario. How much money have you put to invest in your house? a lot of money. And what if it goes just in a twink of an eye? Just in one day you wake up and you're homeless. Why don't you acquire such a fire extinguisher, which goes for even less than 200,000, and make sure your home is safe? So I urge all those parents, all those property owners, make sure you have these equipment in your home. Look at your children. What if your child gets stuck and dies just because you cannot buy a fire extinguisher? Me, I think the human nature, we have a tendency of not minding about when will the fire come. You know, sometimes they tell you, when will the fire come? I was telling you before, I encountered a fire at home. And we lost each and everything at home. That was in 2004. And the cause was from a candle. And the whole house got burnt. I don't have memories when I was young. I don't have those memories. I lost my academic documents of primary. Everyone, we lost a lot of property. Everyone stayed there. A family of 8 people, everyone stayed the way they were. So you can imagine, in one day, you start up from zero. Yeah? And thank God I'm in fire. I already have a fire extinguisher at my home. You know why? Because you don't know. You're not always at home, you're at work. You're working. It is a maid who's at home. Maybe your help at home, or a visitor. They should be always sensitized on these safety tips. Actually, if you have a new visitor, there and then tell them we have a fire extinguisher in the corner. This is how they use it.
Thank you so much, Madam Doreen, for this wonderful topic, for this wonderful session you've taken us through, and I believe our viewers there have really learned a lot on the fire extinguishers. To our viewers, from me and my team, really, we cannot tell you a lot. We can't say much, like more than what she has already told us. Saves life. You know, we always say that prevention is better than cure. So why do you wait for a big tragedy to happen when you can honestly have this at your home? And to our young babies, to our students, to our young generation, each time you see any red element, any red object like this in a home, please don't tamper with it before mommy teaches you, before daddy teaches you, because you will be putting your life in danger. Seek advice and learn how to use it to save the lives of each and everyone. Once again, I will say thank you, our viewers, for the time you've given us. And also, I will not forget to remind you of our Saturday vision. There's a pullout. We always have the homes and constructions. Here you will learn more about this and the rest that we have always been bringing in our previous shows. From me and my team, we want to say thank you very much for your support, for always sticking to Urban. When it comes to Sunday, 7:30 p.m. to 8:30 p.m., you're always tuned and ready to hear from us as the Homes and Construction Affairs Show. Until next time, have a good night.